Hi, and welcome to another edition of Technotes. My name is Tran Langford, and today I want to talk about lighting a stage wash. There are plenty of different ways to light a stage, and with many different lighting fixtures. Things from professional lights such as Leicos, Fresnels, and PARs, to intelligent moving head fixtures, to even track lighting from your local Home Depot. Are any of these the right way or the wrong way? Well, all of these things can be used to light a stage. Because really, at the end of the day, we want to achieve an even wash across the stage to illuminate all the subjects we are trying to light. Fixture selection aside, what we are looking for is front light, rear light, and side light. Now, for those of you who are watching this, don't worry if you're thinking, but I can't do all of those positions in my venue, or I don't have enough fixtures to do that. Do all three of these things need to be used to achieve a stage wash? Well, the answer is no. In priority, I would advise most obviously that front light is the most important, followed by rear light, and then side light. The other thing I want to touch on is zones. Most stages for general purpose light are divided into sections. Those would be stage left, stage right, and center stage. For larger stages, we like to divide that up into more sections of downstage left, downstage center, downstage right, and upstage left, upstage center, and upstage right. Using these three or six zones, usually most areas are covered and can be used for any application, such as a piano player in the center with a singer on the right and a violinist on the left, or a band layout with a drummer in the upstage center with bass upstage left and singer downstage center and a guitar to the left or the right. Now, of course, these are just examples, of course, of how zoned stage can be used with the talent layout. The last thing I would just like to mention before we get into front light is the terminology I've been using, such as upstage center and downstage left, etc. So let's talk a little more about that. Can anybody guess as to why it's called upstage and downstage? Well, back in the day, and I mean a long time ago, it was a stage that was actually raked or tilted, and the audience sat on level ground. So when the actors or actresses performed, and they're at the back of the stage, they were literally upstage, or higher. Thusly, when they're performing at the front of the stage, they're literally downstage. As for the stage right or stage left terminology, it is always from the performer's view. My high school teacher told me that it was because performers had enough to worry about without having to remember left or right. So that is where we get house left and house right from, as that is referring to what the audience sees. So, to simplify, or not, house right, audience view, is stage left, performer's view. So that would mean house left is, wait for it, that's right, stage right. Sort of feels like a Door episode now, doesn't it? Anyways, on with the show.